In this video, I want to share with you how you become a millionaire using property as a vehicle to do that. Listen, around 90% of self-made millionaires, according to some reports, have made their millions via property. A lot of their millions are based in equity, so they're not cash millionaires, but on paper, their net worth is worth a million. So what I mean by their net worth is, basically, if they've got £2 million worth of property, and they've only got £1 million worth of loans against this and lending against this, basically the net worth is worth a million. So if they sold everything up, what they'd be left with is a million. So a lot of self-made millionaires have got it through property. Some of them are homeowners as well, just to be transparent, not always done it through investment. But in this video, I'm going to share with you how you can do that using rental properties. But before I do that, make sure you hit that like button before we get going. Really helps the algorithms out and really helps spread this message. But let's dive into this. So the first thing I will say to you is, basically, if you want to be a millionaire, via property is you'll need one major ingredient. So we're gonna give you six. So let's give you six, put this in a different color. Let's give you six money generators from property. So I'm going to share with you these six money generators. I feel a little bit cringy sharing you this. I must admit, I've done a little bit of research on this. I love Jamie York. See, he done a video as well, and he said about he feels a bit cringe delivering this, which I do, talking about being a millionaire. People ask all the time how much money you've got, how much property you've got, what cash flows. I don't like talking about it, more so because I don't feel like I want to show off, but I do want to give that message out of financial education. So it's very important to me to share with you how you become that. Definitely what I said, I'm definitely in this bracket, not a cash millionaire before anybody else asked. But that said, it's important for people to understand this. Financial education is really, really important. So the first thing I am going to tell you about this is you're going to need patience. It's not get rich quick property. James Sinclair talks about fast pans and slow pans. Building wealth via property is slow pans. If you want passive, the financial freedom via passive income and financial freedom via property, you need to be patient with that. It's not something you do overnight. You get these odd exceptions to the rule, these outliers, these people are just freaks of nature that do it within a month, 6 months, not a month, but 6 months, maybe a year, and build these phenomenal portfolios in a short period of time. But they're outliers. They're outliers like Usain Bolt can run under 10 seconds. Just because you have got the belief and the training and all the other things to do that, you've got a certain innate ability, and some people are just phenomenal business builders and they're the outliers. Like some people, like Usain Bolt, are phenomenal runners. Not all of us, no matter how much we put our mind to it, are going to be able to achieve that. You cannot train a pig into a racehorse, no matter how good the mentor was, no matter how good his belief was, and no matter how much he trained and practiced. So it's about being realistic with you on your journey. But in most cases, it takes time and effort and consistency to be able to do this. Building wealth with property is real residual wealth that gives you a reoccurring income. It's not fully passive, you have to get it managed, but it's a reoccurring income that drops in your account every month. And to get that reoccurring income and to some level of passiveness, you do need to have patience and exercise patience with that. Don't expect this to happen overnight. So I wanted to say a disclaimer there. It took me many years. I've been in property for well over a decade, and it took me a long while to get to where I'm at now, so it wasn't overnight by no means for me. But let's look at the six money generators you're going to get from property. So money generator number one, this is different ways you're going to achieve this millionaire status from these different generators. Number one, which is the reason property is my favorite asset class, is because of this reason, and it is because of cash flow. With property, it cash flows every single month. What you need to buy is properties that give you a cash flow positive. So what I mean by cash flow positive is if your mortgage is £100 a month and you rent it for £600 a month, you've got a positive margin in between to pay for maintenance, pay for voids and all these different things. So you need cash flowing positive properties. This is what builds your wealth. Some people buy properties without no cash flow and just pay them down. And it's not really building wealth, it's just a savings pot. So this will build your wealth. Cash flow is my number one reason I like property over any other asset class. I've got most other asset classes, but prefer property over this because it gives you reoccurring income in your bank every single month. So second generator of money from property is capital appreciation, so capital growth. So sorry for the spelling on these, I am dyslexic. This whiteboard is just to give you a bit of a visual rather than a grammatical lesson on how to spell. But look, capital growth is the second generator you're going to get from that. So over years, on average, properties grow about 5-6% per year across the whole of UK. Some areas have bigger growth, some have slower growth, but in general, prices go up. Do I think this is going to go on forever? No, but I think there is little pockets of areas where the price per earnings ratio, so whatever people earn on average salaries in comparison to what the average price is, I think these areas are stronger and more positioned to grow, especially these areas in the north that are getting infrastructure there and the jobs are coming back to that. That's not for this video here. I've done plenty of videos on this, so check out the recommendations for that. But a lot of millionaires do get made from capital appreciation, especially people just own their own home. Like people bought property in London in the 1930s, about 30 years ago, sorry, not the 1930s. They'd definitely be millionaires if they're still alive. But people bought property in London in the 1980s, in the 1990s. A lot of these are asset millionaires because their properties appreciate so much. The only thing with the capital stuff in there is unless you loan against that, that's just a feel-good factor. It just makes you feel good because that's what you're worth. Your net worth is that. But what makes you pay for all your bills and pays for your holidays, pays for your fuel, your increased cost of fuel and the increased cost of living is cash flow. Cash flow is king, much more important than the asset prices. As long as you fix your interest rates for a long enough period of time, it don't matter what the asset price does, as long as your cash flow coming in every single month. Money generator number three is your loan pay down. So when you've got a loan against a property, a lot of time it is interest only. Sorry about the spelling now. A lot of time it is interest only, but often when you grow a bit larger, you might strategically put in some repayments and pay down these loans. So your tenant, you're not paying the loan down, your tenant who you're renting the property at from is paying that loan down, and you still should get a margin and a profit and cash flow in between when you buy the right style property. So this is another generator of that to building out your wealth, and it slowly just chips away and builds your wealth. Money generator number four from property is inflation. So most properties will be bought on a loan, so not unencumbered. So what happens is inflation erodes your debt away. So the buying power of £100,000 in just 1 year from today at the time of recording this, inflation sits at just about 10%, not far away from it. Real inflation is probably higher. The government are reporting it, or the Bank of England reporting it, just under 10%. But let's just say 10%. So your buying power is losing 10% per year. So in real time, what this means is what you can buy for 100 grand today, you're going to have to pay £110,000 for next year. So if you've got debt on a property, that debt is getting shrunk. That debt is frozen in time on what you bought it at, but the buying power, prices of buying houses are more expensive, prices of buying your fuel and all these other things, and this cost of living goes up, means that your debt is getting shrunk. So it's building you more wealth via inflation. Money generator number five is leverage. The main reason I like property as well, above a lot of assets, I buy gold, I buy crypto, I buy these other assets, watches and stocks and all these things. But the thing I love about property is leverage. You can leverage 75%, even up to 80% of the value of that property, then get all these above benefits. So if I go to the bank, say this is a 100K property, and I go to the bank with, let's say, look, I'm buying this property over here, it might get a little bit messy, but I'm buying this property over here, the value of this property is say 100K, just for easy math. So this property is worth 100K. I can go to the bank with 25K as a deposit, and the bank will put in the 75K difference. This is called leverage. So I've only put 25K in and the bank put 75K in. This is the power of it. Like I bought this one property for 100K, and say if I rented it for, I don't know, £600 per month, I would only get one £600. With 100K, I can buy four properties and get £600 times four and have a mortgage of, say, 150. I don't know exact amounts here, so don't quote this, but let's say for easy math, I might have a mortgage of 150 times four, which gives me a £600 a month mortgage, but I've got £2,400 coming in rental income as opposed to £600 from one loan. But the power of this leverage as well is not only can I make my pounds sweat my pounds and sweat my assets and make them work harder, the power of this is all the you earn the interest and the money of the bank's money, so a lot more money, and you also earn all the capital appreciation. So if this property here over the years goes up 5% over the next 10 years as an average at 5%, and there's 50k, let's bring this up here. If there's 50k worth of added capital appreciation, so cap growth is 50k on this, that 50k is 100% yours or mine or whoever owns that property to keep. You don't, the bank don't say, well, I've got 75% of the money into this deal, you've only got 25%, so I want 75% of that 50k, you can have the rest. That don't, just don't happen. Thankfully you get 100% of that. So leverage in property is absolutely ginormous. You can't do this with stocks, you can't do this with cryptos, you can't do this with gold or any other asset class. Businesses you can do to a degree, but often banks won't lend you 75 or 80% of that business value. The reason they do that on property, because it's such a commodity, it's a strong commodity. You will undersupply the properties, and like we're still not building enough properties. So the saying, as safe as houses, is pretty good saying, because it is a safe asset class, and the bank show you that. If you went into the bank tomorrow and said to them, look, went into Lloyd's in the high street, said, look, I want to lend some money to buy some stocks. The stocks I want to buy is the stocks within your company. I want to buy some Lloyd's shares and stocks. Can you give me £75,000 or £25,000 to put to it? Let's say no, they'd probably laugh you out of the bank, because they would give you absolutely zero, even though you're investing in their business. But they will give an absolutely newbie with no experience 75 up to 80% of the value of that property, with no landlord, no previous experience, no exams passed. If you was a business owner, again, they're going to want to see your experience. They might lend you 50%. So property is the greatest leverage asset you can get, and you get the full benefits from all the uplift appreciations that you get from that. Right at number six, got my fingers there. Money generating number six is compound interest. So compound effect. So if you compound, like you're compounding all your capital appreciation, all your cash flow, maybe not all of it, but a percentage of it, and you keep on building it in. So the idea is, look, if you buy 10 of these houses that's giving you a cash flow, say, as I said, you're £600, you're £150 mortgage, you've got £50 management fees, and let's say you're left with £300 in your pocket each time. If you've got 10 of these, and let's say you've got a few voids, so you've got £3,000 a month, so let's drop that down to £2,500 a month. So if you've got this 10 of these properties, so times 10 of these properties, and it nets you after cost and voids and maintenance and everything, 2.5k. You might put 2.5, that 2.5k, if you're not living out, you've got another job, you might put that back in. So if you've got 100k property, it's only going to take you another 10 months to be able to save up the money to buy for another deposit for one of these. So then you're compounding that money that you're putting into it. Also, you can compound the capital appreciation. So if that value goes up, you can lend against this new value at 150 and pull some more money out and put it back in into these deals. It's not BRR, this is just blending off the appreciation and building and compounding what you've got. This will build you wealth over a long period of time. If you want to know more about how to get started in property, make sure you watch this video here. We'll talk about the property data matrix. We'll talk it briefly on there, but not to talk too much. To get started in property, if you're not started, you need money, you need knowledge, you need network, and in the middle of that, I'm going to put this in red, you're going to need some time. And then when you put this together in this delta matrix, put it together, is how you build out wealth in properties like securely and sustainably. Is there's different types of property investments. You've got buy to let sitting down the bottom, which is your vanilla buy to let family homes. You've got HMOs and SAs above that. You've got commercial conversion above that and development above that. The higher you go up, the more wealth generation you do, but the more skill and experience you need for that. So what you want to do is build out a good foundation of single debt properties, then go to higher cash flow, a bit more higher strategy, more knowledge needed, more cash needed to develop these and do these. Then go up to HMO and SAs, then commercial conversions in development. You follow that path upwards, and over a period of time, compound your interest, stay patient with it, don't expect it to happen overnight, then you will build a sustainable income and sustainable wealth via property. So listen, if you're still here, massive well done for staying the duration. Please, my why is to live in my terms. My mission is to help as many people live in their terms using property as a vehicle to do this. So please share this out to people you think will find this valuable. Share this to them. Please comment below if you've got any questions. I will do my best to answer all the comments. Give it a like. Hit the subscribe button if you haven't already. Hit the bell icon so you get notified every time we do videos like this. But remember, if you don't evolve your ideas, you never live on your own terms. So evolve your ideas, live on your own terms. Have an amazing day.